हेलो क्लास, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द लिविंग वर्ल्ड, बायोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन। द साइंटिफिक वे ऑफ आइडेंटिफाइंग, नेमिंग एंड ग्रुपिंग ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स बेस्ड ऑन सिमिलैरिटीज एंड डिफरेंसेस इज नोन एज बायोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन। We can take one example. When we go to the school library for a certain book, we go to the particular place to access a certain category of book. But if books are not arranged systematically, then what will happen? We will find difficulty to get that particular book through the thousands of books in all the shelves. Clear, children? Similarly, there are nearly 30 million types of living organisms present on Earth. So it would be impossible to locate and study each of them separately as individual organisms. So based on certain common characteristics, scientists have identified and placed them under separate groups at different levels. Students, there are many advantages of classification. Let's see one by one. The first one is classification makes the study of living organisms systematic and simple. Next, classification helps in identifying different organisms and placing them in groups. We know that on Earth, millions of animals are present, so scientists first they identify those animals and then place them into groups according to their characteristic features. Next, it helps to generalize the characteristics of a group so that we do not have to memorize the characteristics of each member of the group. Class, it is not easy to learn the characteristic features of each and everyone. But if there is any group in which same type of organisms are there, whose some characteristic features are almost same, then it will be easy for us to learn their characteristics. Next, it highlights the relationship between different organisms. Class, classification helps us to find out that how one organism or one group is related to another group or another organism. Next and last, it gives an idea about the evolution of organisms from simpler to more complex ones. Idea about the evolution. You know, children, what is evolution? Evolution is the way in which living things change and develop over millions of years. Changes occur. Evolution is a process that results in a changes in the genetic material of a population over time. Our next topic is systems of classification. There are two broad systems of classification. The first one is the artificial system and the second one is the natural system. Two systems of classification are there. The first one, the artificial system, and the second one is the natural system. Now we will discuss the first one, the artificial system. The Greek philosopher Aristotle was the first to classify animals. Clear? He grouped animals based on simple visible characters, means characters which were visible in animals. On basis of that, he grouped them, such as the presence or absence of red blood, whether they lay eggs or give birth to babies, whether their body covering is hard or soft, whether they have wings or legs, and so on. But In this kind of grouping, the major disadvantage was that the organisms that were otherwise very different were likely to be placed in the same group. Means, Aristotle kept those animals also in one group who were totally different from each other. For example, he kept birds and insects in one group only on the basis of presence or absence of wings. And these types of classifications continued till the middle of the 18th century. The second system of classification is natural system of classification, in which first we will see the two kingdom system. In 1758, Carolus Linnaeus, a Swedish botanist, is popularly known as the father of taxonomy, classified all living organisms in two separate kingdoms. First one, Plantae or plant kingdom, and the second one is Animalia or animal kingdom. In plant kingdom, he kept those organisms who were stationary and could prepare food on their own. And in animal kingdom, he kept those organisms that could move but not prepare food on their own. This system came to be known as the two kingdom classification system, or the modern system of classification. Linnaeus' general plan of classification. Linnaeus established taxonomic ranks, that is different levels, while grouping organisms. The group at the top level had the least number of common features. As the order progressed to lower levels, the organisms had more features in common. Thus, the organisms at a lower taxonomic rank were related more closely than the organisms at the level above it. We still use these taxonomical labels today. As you know, class, Linnaeus classified all living organisms in two separate kingdoms, plant kingdoms and animal kingdoms. Kingdom is the largest unit. It is the largest unit of classification, whereas species is the smallest one. So all living organisms are divided into two kingdoms, plants and animals. The next level of division in the plant, if we take plant kingdom, then the next level will be division. And if we will take animal kingdom, then the next division will be phylum. Clear, children? If we will take plant kingdom, then the next level will be division. Plant kingdom further divides into division. And if we talk about animal kingdom, then after kingdom, phylum will come. Phylum is the singular form. Plural will be phyla, P-H-Y-L-A, phyla. A phylum or division is divided further into many classes. The next level will be classes. After class, order will come. The next level will be order. A class has a number of orders. Under an order come many families. Clear, class? Under an order come many families. Organisms belonging to the same family are very similar in structure. Clear? Those organisms which belong to same family, their structures will be very similar. Every family is divided into many genera or genus. Singular form is genus. Plural will be genera. The members of a genus are much more similar than those of a family. Now each genus is further divided into many species. Class, I have already told you that species is the smallest unit of classification. Members of a species resemble each other very closely. They have similar body parts, live in similar habitats, and can reproduce among themselves. We can take example of human beings. You are also human beings, I am also. If we see the structures of our hands or legs, it is same. Your hand is same as my hand. So, members of a species resemble each other very closely, and they reproduce, members of species reproduce among themselves. The two kingdom system of classification had certain drawbacks. Both eukaryotes and prokaryotes were placed together. They were kept together in the two kingdoms. It was a drawback of this classification. In plant kingdom, there were species which were photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic. Means in plant kingdom, both types of species were there. Those who are photosynthetic or non-photosynthetic. So those species placed together in this system. That was also a drawback of this classification. Next drawback, there were some animals which show both animals as well as plants' character. So no fixed position was there for them. In this we can take example of Euglena. Most species of Euglena have photosynthesizing chloroplasts within the body of the cell, which enable them to feed by autotrophy like plants. This is the characteristic feature of plants. Because they contain chlorophyll, so they can prepare their own food. Other characteristic features are, they live in water, move by means of a flagellum. They do not have cell wall. So these all characteristic features are of animals. Next drawback, this system of classification did not consider viruses since they were not properly known at that time. Next, certain organisms such as bacteria and fungi were included in the plant kingdom, while protozoans were included in the animal kingdom. But some of these organisms were found to have characteristics that were neither typically plant-like nor animal-like. Another drawback, fungi were kept under plant kingdom even though they do not contain chlorophyll and therefore cannot prepare their own food. Class, as you know that the main characteristic of plant is that they contain chlorophyll and they can prepare their own food. But what about fungi? They do not contain chlorophyll, then also they were kept in plant kingdom. So it was the drawback. It was drawback of that classification. To overcome these disadvantages, in 1969, the American plant biologist R. H. Whitaker suggested the five kingdom classification. And this five kingdom classification we will discuss in our next video.